सारा खान, आप देख रहे हैं न्यूज 21 टीवी। आइए देखते हैं आज की यह खास।
मेरा नाम है अरुण बिस्ला, मेरी उम्र है 28 साल और मैं फरीदाबाद शहर का रहने वाला हूँ। मैंने अपनी इंजीनियरिंग आर्मी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे
से एकेडमी, व्हिच इज एट नवी मुंबई। माय स्कूल हैज स्टार्टेड 10 इयर्स बैक। इट इज एन आईसीसी स्कूल एंड द ट्रस्टीज एंड द मैनेजमेंट डज एवरीथिंग दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द स्कूल। As far as Ankarwala Education Academy is concerned, we look into the all-round development of the students, wherein it's not only academics but even the sports that we concentrate on. Recently, we have won awards for the best innovative teaching and the STEAM lab that has been started recently. We believe in inculcating not only academics, but it is also extracurricular and curricular activities that we inculcate.
Ma'am, along with the talking about the innovative teaching, yes, as you mentioned, so how can you put it into the question that how can we improve our education system through innovative teaching or whatever extra stuff we can add? So what we can do to improve the education system of our country?
As you see, as soon as a child is born, the parents try to gain the attention through media, that is the mobile. The children are given the mobile. Now it shows that nowadays the children are interested not only in oral teaching but through visual learning. So what we need to do is we have to inculcate education along with audio visual aids. Okay. And it is not only the examination system, okay, it is the regular understanding of the child that we are looking into. Okay. So here we don't have unit tests as such, but it is the continuous comprehensive evaluation that happens. That is, after every chapter, the children are assessed. Okay. Now, assess if the child is not doing well, it is not that the child fails. Okay. We keep on assessing the child till the child has understood the basic concepts of that particular topic or the chapter.
Okay. So moving onwards to the second question. My second question is, nowadays moral education is a very important topic which is lowering nowadays. So who do you think is responsible for this? The parents, the teachers or the society?
See, it is not, as we say, no, with one hand you cannot clap. Okay. So it is not only the parents, it is not only the teachers, but it is together that we have to inculcate the moral values. Like, we over here strongly believe in inculcating the moral values. So my pre-primary section, if you see this annual day, the performing on Ramayana. Okay? Ramayana teaches you a lot of moral values. Respect for elders, respect for your near and dear ones, respect for the people around you, and the love that is inculcated. So I would want you all to come and see on Saturday what my small kids are doing. It is a pre-primary section, so you have the junior KG, senior KG and the nursery students who are involved in doing the Ramayana.
Okay.
So I think you'll get a hands-on experience if you come and really have a look at what the kids are doing. Okay. How we inculcate moral value. It is just not by saying, it is by doing that we can inculcate moral values.
So my last question is, nowadays sex education is important in the syllabus. So do you think how far it is important? Give me your views on that. At how far it is important in the syllabus? Because in some of the schools, they avoid to teach the particular chapter.
I don't think we should be reluctant or hesitant to teach sex education, because it is one of the most important things. So that children are trained in the right manner. They should know what is the importance of their private parts, how are they using it. Okay, all this is very important. So sex education becomes important. In the sense, a girl and a boy talking, it's not necessary that you have to take it always in the wrong angle. They could be basically friends. Okay, but yes, we have to guide them what limit they should not be crossing. So sex education is equally important.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.